So in this video, I will cover the basics of FIR and IIR filter and their graphical representation. So starting with digital filters, it is a very important part of DSP system and it has two main operations. First is signal restoration and second is signal separation. So signal restoration is used when a signal has been distorted in some way, and signal separation is needed when a signal has been contaminated with interference, noise or other signal. So we can say that filters are primarily modifying these frequency properties of input signal Xn. So Xn is a discrete time digital signal in this case. So these filters can be characterized by unit sample response Hn or frequency response in frequency domain, that is H of Eg omega, or in Z domain we can use transfer function Hz. We can also use difference equation to represent these filters, and this is a important form because we will be using this difference equation representation again and again in this course. So this representation shows the computation required to implement the filter. So LTI and a causal filter is described by the following difference equation. So Yn is sum of two terms. First term is minus summation k equal to 1 to n e of k y of n minus k. So y of n minus k is past output. And second term is k equal to 0 to m minus 1 b of k x of n minus k. This x of n minus k is input sample, so for k equal to 0 it is x of n, that is present input sample. And for k not equal to 0 this is x of n minus k, so this is past input sample. So Yn depends on two terms, past output and present and past input sample as well. So if Ak is 0, Ak and Bk are constant coefficient. So if Ak is 0 for all values of k, then Yn converges to this equation. Yn is equal to k equal to 0 to m minus 1 b of k x of n minus k. So this equation is representing a MTAP finite impulse response filter, FIR filter, and this is a non-recursive computation. The unit sample response HK is given by BK for all values of K. Now if at least one AK is not zero, so if any coefficient AK is not zero, then Y will depend on its own value as well as input value. So this kind of relation where the value function y depends on its own past value, this kind of relation is called recurrence relation. So this is a recursive computation, and this equation represents an infinite impulse response IIR filter, and its unit sample response has infinite duration. So at higher level of digital VLSI design, systems are represented using mathematical formula. So this equation is representing a specific three-tap FIR filter. So Yn is equal to A of Xn plus B of Xn minus 1 plus C of Xn minus 3. This mathematical equation is representing a three-tap filter. And the second equation, that is Yn is equal to A of Yn minus 1 plus B of Xn. This equation is representing a specific IIR filter, and these are non-terminating programs and it executes same code again and again. It means that same computation will be done on different samples. So samples starting from n equal to 1 to infinity, same computation will be done again and again. So this higher level representation need to be converted to architectural representation, and for that we can use either behavioral representation और ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन. सो ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन इज़ पार्ट ऑफ अवर सिलेबस एंड वी विल डिस्कस दिस फॉर डिफरेंट FIR एंड IIR फिल्टर्स. तो इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट इन द सेंस दैट इट इज़ एफिशिएंट फॉर इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग एंड एनालाइजिंग डाटा फ्लो प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ DSP सिस्टम एंड इट कैन बी यूज टू मैप DSP एल्गोरिदम टू हार्डवेयर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन एंड इट इज़ हेल्पफुल इन एक्सप्लोरिंग अप्रोप्रिएट आर्किटेक्चर इन अ टेक्नोलॉजिकल इंडिपेंडेंट मैनर. सो दिस टेक्नोलॉजी सेलेक्टिंग अ प्रॉपर टेक्नोलॉजी इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर चिप डिज़ाइनिंग. सो चिप डिज़ाइनिंग इज़ लास्ट स्टेज बट एट दिस स्टेज वी डोंट नीड टू वरी अबाउट दिस टेक्नोलॉजी. वी कैन डिज़ाइन मॉडिफाई मैनिपुलेट द सर्किट्स विदाउट वरिंग अबाउट द टेक्नोलॉजी. सो फोर डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स आर यूज टू रिप्रेजेंट एनी आर्किटेक्चर ग्राफिकली. फर्स्ट इज ब्लॉक डायग्राम रिप्रेजेंटेशन, सेकेंड इज सिग्नल फ्लो रिप्रेजेंटेशन, थर्ड इज डाटा फ्लो ग्राफ एंड द लास्ट वन इज डिपेंडेंस ग्राफ. सो वी विल डिस्कस ऑल दिस रिप्रेजेंटेशन वन बाई वन इन डिटेल. सो बिफोर मूविंग टू ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन वी विल सी सम इम्पॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशन. सो फर्स्ट इज इटरेशन. सो इट इज़ डिफाइंड एज एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ ऑल द कंप्यूटेशन इन द एल्गोरिदम वंस एंड इटरेशन पीरियड इज डिफाइंड एज टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ वन इटरेशन ऑफ द एल्गोरिदम एंड इटरेशन रेट इज इनवर्स ऑफ इटरेशन पीरियड. नेक्स्ट इज क्रिटिकल पाथ. सो इन अ डिजिटल लॉजिक सर्किट इट इज़ द लॉन्गेस्ट सेट ऑफ कॉम्बिनेशनल एलिमेंट एंड दैट टू इन सीरीज विदाउट एनी डिले एलिमेंट. सो दिस क्रिटिकल पाथ कॉन्सेप्ट इज़ वेरी क्रूशियल वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज वी हैव टू ऑप्टिमाइज दिस टू इंक्रीज द स्पीड ऑफ द सिस्टम. सो इट डिटरमाइंस द मिनिमम फिजिबल क्लॉक पीरियड ऑफ DSP सिस्टम. सो इन दैट सेंस इट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नेक्स्ट इज सैम्पलिंग रेट ऑल्सो नोन एज थ्रूपुट. सैम्पल्स प्रोसेस पर सेकेंड और यू कैन सी आउटपुट प्रोड्यूस पर सेकेंड. सो द क्लॉक रेट ऑफ अ DSP सिस्टम मे नॉट बी इक्वल टू द सैम्पलिंग रेट. इट कैन बी इक्वल टू सैम्पलिंग रेट बट इट इज़ नॉट नेसेसरी दैट इट शुड बी इक्वल टू सैम्पलिंग रेट. सो वी विल बी लुकिंग सम मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशन इन द लेटर पार्ट. नाउ वी विल मूव टू ब्लॉक डायग्राम रिप्रेजेंटेशन. सो ब्लॉक डायग्राम रिप्रेजेंटेशन इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर्म ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटेशन एंड इट इज़ मोस्ट फ्रिक्वेंटली यूज टू रिप्रेजेंट DSP सिस्टम्स एंड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द सिस्टम्स कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड यूजिंग ब्लॉक डायग्राम. सो इट इज़ वेरी क्लोज टू सर्किट डायग्राम. सो वॉट वी हैव टू डू वी हैव टू प्रॉपरली चूज द फंक्शनल ब्लॉक्स एंड दीज फंक्शनल ब्लॉक्स कैन बी कनेक्टेड वाया डायरेक्टेड एजेस. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई वॉन्ट टू रिप्रेजेंट दिस FIR फिल्टर यूजिंग ब्लॉक डायग्राम सो आई हैव टू चूज द फंक्शनल ब्लॉक्स एंड देन आई कैन कनेक्ट दिस फंक्शनल ब्लॉक्स इन सम मैनर टू अचीव दिस फंक्शनैलिटी. सो फंक्शनल ब्लॉक्स रिक्वायर्ड आर एडर हेयर टू एड ऑपरेशन इज देयर एंड थ्री मल्टीप्लाई ऑपरेशन इज देयर. सो थ्री मल्टीप्लायर इज रिक्वायर्ड एंड दिस xn माइनस वन एंड xn माइनस टू आर पास्ट वैल्यूज ऑफ इनपुट. सो वी हैव टू स्टोर देम बिकॉज द करंट वैल्यू ऑफ इनपुट विल बी xn. सो वी हैव टू स्टोर दिस पास्ट वैल्यू फॉर दिस. वी रिक्वायर शिफ्ट रजिस्टर और डिले एलिमेंट और स्टोरेज एलिमेंट एंड दीज आर मल्टीबिट. मल्टीबिट इन द सेंस दैट xn इज अ मल्टीबिट सिग्नल. सो इट कैन हैव एन नंबर ऑफ बिट्स एन कैन बी 8, 16, 64 डिपेंडिंग ऑन द सिस्टम. सो एट दिस पॉइंट वी आर नॉट वरिंग अबाउट बिट वाइज रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ सिग्नल्स. वी विल जस्ट रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय एक्स एन वाई एन लाइक दिस. सो दिस स्टोरेज एलिमेंट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय दिस सिंबल एंड इट इज़ अ मल्टीबिट स्टोरेज एलिमेंट. सो आफ्टर आइडेंटिफाइंग द प्रॉपर फंक्शनल ब्लॉक्स नाउ आई हैव टू कनेक्ट देम in a proper way to achieve the functionality. So a block diagram for the FIR filter is given, and it is called a direct form architecture. So three multipliers are implemented in parallel. So this multiplier M0 is multiplying B0 with Xn. This multiplier M1 is multiplying B1 with Xn minus 1. And this multiplier M2 is multiplying B2 with Xn minus 2. And the adder A0, we have two add operations. So adder A0 will add the output of M0 and M1. And it will produce output B0 Xn plus B1 Xn minus 1. And after that, adder A1 will add output produced by A0 and M2. And finally, this output will be generated. And we have to use two delay elements. So suppose we have input samples. This is representing input samples, and suppose this is Xn. The system is currently processing this sample, and suppose this is sample A, this is B and C, and system is currently processing sample C. So Xn minus 1, that is one sample, one previous sample with respect to Xn, that is sample number B. So this storage element is storing sample number B. So this is Xn minus 1. And this storage element is storing two previous samples with respect to Xn and one previous sample with respect to Xn minus 1. So this is storing sample number A, that is X of, this will be X of N minus 2 in this case. So this is current sample that the system is processing. Xn is at this point. This element is storing sample B, and this is storing sample A. So three input samples. This is present one, and two past samples are currently in this system. Now talking about the computation time, so the multiplier will multiply these signals concurrently. Multiply operation is in parallel. So let's say time taken by multiplier is Tm, and after multiplication, adder A0 will first add the signals generated by M0 and M1. So let's say it is taking time Ta, and when A0 produces output, A1 will finally combine that signal produced by M2 and A0. So another Ta time is required. So the final computation time is Tm plus 2 Ta. So talking about critical path, because this is an important factor, it determines the minimum clock frequency. So we have to determine critical path for almost every circuit. So critical path is the longest set of combinational element in series without any delay element in between. So it can be seen that M0, A0 and A1 are in series. So M0, A0, A1 are in series. And we have M1, A0 and A1 in series. So one multiplier followed by two adder. Same here, one multiplier followed by two adder. And critical path time is, we can calculate critical path time by calculating the computation time of this element that are in series. So Tm for multiplier, and Ta plus Ta, that is 2 Ta for adder. So this is Tm plus 2 Ta, and this is also Tm plus 2 Ta. So by using either the critical path concept or this logic, we can calculate the computation time. And clock period is always greater than or equal to critical path time. If this clock period is less than critical path, then this functional block will start processing. Suppose Xn is being processed and yn is not generated and clock arrives. So next sample will be loaded to this shift register and this blocks will start processing xn plus 1, and before the generation of yn the system will start processing xn plus 1. So this can result in a faulty output. So it is important that clock period should be greater than critical path time. Means if you have provided xn, then you have to wait till you receive the corresponding output sample. After that, you provide next sample. So this direct form architecture is not unique. Other variants are possible, and we have used functional blocks of size 2 cross 1, that is 2 input and 1 output for adder and multiplier. So n input functional blocks can also be used. So this choice of the functional block is important. So it is important in terms of area, speed, power, and other factors. So here a second architecture for the same FIR filter is drawn, and this is known as broadcast architecture because xn is broadcasted to all the multipliers. B2 is multiplied with xn and B1 is also multiplied with xn and B0 is also multiplied with xn, and adder A0 will add B1 xn plus B2 xn minus 1, and the output will be loaded to this shift register, and this adder will add output provided by this shift register and multiplier M2, and it will generate B0 xn, B1 xn minus 1, and B2 xn minus 2. So critical path for this architecture can be determined in the same manner, and we can see that longest combinational elements in series are M2 and A1, and here it is M1 and A0. Both paths are similar, both consist of one multiplier and one adder. So we can compute critical path time by adding the computation time of these elements. So TM for multiplier and TA for adder. Total critical path time is TM plus TA. So two architectures has been drawn for the same FIR filter. First was direct form and second was broadcast structure. So now we can compare these two structures based on critical path time, fan out, and size of shift register. So first criteria, that is critical path time. So for direct form it was TM plus 2TA, and for broadcast structure it is TM plus TA. So it can be seen that the critical time path is less for broadcast structure. So in that sense this structure is better. Now talking about fan out, so we can say that fan out of input signal, that is this xn is generated by some input source. So fan out of this input source is, let's say it is 1 if we ignore the register, because it is only driving this multiplier. We can ignore shift register at this point. So fan out is equal to 1, and for this broadcast structure fan out is 3. This source is driving 3 multiplier. So in this case fan out is 1, less power is required. In this case fan out is 3, more power is required by the input source to drive the 3 multipliers. And talking about shift register, so if xn is n bit, size of the register will be also n bit. Here xn is directly stored to shift register, these two shift registers. These are input samples and these are directly stored to this shift registers. So if xn is of n bit, this register will be also of n bit.
And for broadcast structure, if xn is of n bit, so xn is multiplied by b2 at this point, b1 at this point, and b0 at this point. So this shift register is storing the product of b2 and xn. So this can be greater than n bit. Also b1 into xn can be greater than n bit. So b0 xn and b1 xn minus 1 can be greater than n bits. So in that case, size of the shift register should be greater than n bit. So broadcast structure is better in terms of critical path time, but the fan out is more, so more power is required to drive three multipliers, and size of the shift register is larger as compared to the size of shift register in direct form.
So IIR filter can also be represented by using the block diagram. So this is a typical IIR filter where yn is equal to fyn minus 1 plus xn, and only one add operation is required and one multiplication is required, and we need to store only one output sample. So one adder, one multiplier, and one shift register. So this adder is adding xn and stored value, this is yn, and this will be stored yn minus 1, and it is multiplied by a. So this is adding xn and a of yn minus 1, and it is generating yn. At the same time, this is getting stored in this shift register. So when next sample arrives, it will add yn minus 1, the previous sample, multiplied by a, and the input value. So critical path time can be calculated by finding the combinational element in series. So here we can see that adder and multiplier is in series, and critical path time can be added by adding their computation time, that is tm plus ta, similar to that in broadcast structure. So final note, a block diagram is close to hardware representation, and if all functional blocks are available, the circuit can be realized by simply connecting them using wires. Moving to next graphical representation form, and that is a signal flow graph. It is not much helpful for hardware representation, and it is specific to linear time invariant systems, whereas block diagram is not restricted to LTI system. Block diagram can be used to represent any kind of system, whether it is linear, non-linear, single rate, multi-rate, any kind of system. Signal flow graph is useful to represent signals in Z transfer domain, and since we can represent the signal flow in Z transform domain, so we can do many important analysis like calculating transfer function HZ for any circuit. So to represent any circuit using SFG, the main components required are nodes that represent computation, task or process. Example is adder splitter. So this is a representation of adder. It is just represented by a small dot, and it is a two input one output adder. So it will add two signals, that is a1 x1n, and second signal is a2 x2n, and the output is the addition of these two signals, a1 x1n plus a2 x2n. Similar representation can be used for another computation process, and this is a example of splitter. It is taking one signal xn, and it is branching xn to two different branches as it is, xn in this branch and xn in another branch. This is an example of source node. This generates the signal xn. This node is having only one outgoing edge. It can have multiple outgoing edge, but in this case it is having only one outgoing edge, and there is no incoming edge. This is an example of sync node. This node is having only incoming edges and no outgoing edges there. These nodes are connected via directed edges. So a directed edge between j comma k is a branch originate from node j and terminate at node k, and it denotes linear transformation of signal at node j to signal at node k.
So linear transformation means this signal at node j will be multiplied by a constant. That is, this constant is the weight of this h. So in this case, the weight of h between j and k is a, and signal present at node j is xn. So at node k, this signal will be multiplied by a, and at k we will receive a into xn. So we can also perform delay operation or storage operation by specifying the weight as z inverse. So suppose the signal at node j is xn and we have added weight as z inverse. So the signal at k will be x of n minus 1, that is delayed version of xn. So suppose the sample at node j is b at present. So at node k, the sample will be a, one cycle delayed. Now in next cycle, c will arrive at node j, and at that instant at node k, b will be there. Now in next cycle, d will arrive at node j, and at k, c will be there. So there is a gap of one cycle. So now by using nodes and directed edges, we can represent the same FIR filter. So we need two adder nodes and one sink node, one source node, and this multiply operation will be represented by adding weight to this directed edges and to branch xn and different signals into multiple branches, we require splitter nodes. So this is representing a direct form SFG for this FIR filter. So a source node is required, it is generating xn. This is a splitter, this is branching this xn into two different branch as it is. In this branch, this xn is getting multiplied with b0, and in this branch it is getting multiplied by z inverse. So this is a delay operation, this is a scalar multiplication operation. So at this point the signal is a delayed version of xn, so it is x of n minus 1, and this is again a delayed version, so at this point we have xn minus 2. At this point we have output b0 xn, and in this branch the output will be b1 xn minus 1. This adder is adding these two signals, so it will add b0 xn plus b1 xn minus 1. Further, this xn minus 2 will be multiplied by b2, and this adder will add b0 xn plus b1 xn minus 1 with b2 xn minus 2. So this is a direct form SFG for this particular FIR filter. So as mentioned earlier, that this architecture is not unique for this particular filter, other variants are possible. So in this SFG case, especially in SFG case, we can achieve alternative structure by performing transposition or flow graph reversal techniques. So the steps to do this transposition or flow graph reversal techniques are: first, reverse direction of all edges. Suppose we have this direct form architecture, direct form SFG for this filter. What we have to do, we have to reverse the direction of all edges in this architecture. Then we have to exchange input and output nodes, and the weight of the edge need not to be changed, it will remain unchanged, and then exchange adder and splitter. So by doing this following steps, we can achieve a alternative structure, and that structure is called transpose form. So here you can see that xn is replaced with yn and yn is replaced with xn, and direction of all edges is reversed.
direction of all edges is reversed. The weight of edges are not changed. It is B0, B1, B2 here, same as in direct form. Z inverse in this case, same as in direct form. And adder and splitters are exchanged. So now this node is representing adders, and this node in green color is representing splitter. So we can easily verify that this transpose form is achieving the same functionality. So suppose this is node 1, this is node 2, and this is node 3. So at 1, we have xn multiplied by b2. And this xn is also multiplied by b1. So suppose this is node 2. So this node 2 is having two input. One is b2 xn delayed by one cycle. So this is b2 xn minus 1. And second is xn multiplied by b1. X minus 1. So the output is, sorry, this is xn. So the output is b1 xn plus b2 n minus 2. And this output of this node 2 is again delayed by one cycle, that is Z inverse, and this is getting added with B0 xn. So input of 3 is B0 xn. And this is this output delayed by one cycle. So this is B1 X and minus 1 plus B2 X of N minus 2. And output of 3 is this function. So important note that direct form and broadcast form that we have seen in block diagram architecture can be obtained from this SFG form. There we have drawn directly, but if we use SFG, we can convert this in a similar block diagram form. So SFG can also be used to represent IIR filters, and we are using the same filter again. So components required to implement these filters are adder node for add operation and splitter nodes and source and sink node. So this is a source node, yn is a sink node, this is adder, and this is a splitter. So this adder is adding two signals. One signal is xn and second signal is multiplied by a and delayed by one cycle. So input to this adder is, this is yn multiplied by a delayed by one cycle. So a times y of n minus 1, and output is xn plus y of n minus 1 multiplied by. So this is how you can implement any LTI system using SFG representation. Data flow graph is another method that can be used to represent a DSP system. So it consists of nodes that represents computation, example adder node, multiplier node, and these nodes are connected via directed edges that represent data path, and each edge is associated with a non-negative delay. So suppose this is node A and this is node B, and this is a directed edge between E and B. So if the weight is, suppose 1, nothing is mentioned over here, so weight is 1, it will be considered as 0 delay. And we can add delay, 1 delay. If we want to delay the result of node A by 1 cycle, then we can add 1 delay. If you want to delay it by 2 cycle, then we can add 2 delay. So delay operation is specified by adding weight to this edge. So this DFG captures data driven property of DSP system, and there is a concept of node firing in context to data flow graph. It means performing computation. So these nodes are performing computation. So whenever it perform computation and generate output, we say that node has fired. So when a node can fire, when all input data are available. So source node with no input edge can fire at any time. And a node, suppose this node is having multiple input, so this is J, this is K. So these J and K are precedent node with respect to A. So A can only fire when node J and K have fired. So this imposes a precedence constraint. First is intra iteration. If edge has zero delay, so if suppose this is node J and A and this edge is having no delay element, zero delay, so we say that there is a intra iteration precedent constraint between J and A. And suppose I add a delay 1 here, D. So if the edge has one or more delay, so we say that there is a inter iteration precedence constraint. So node K and A are having inter iteration precedence constraint. Together, intra and inter iteration precedence constraints specify the order in which the node can be executed in a DFG. DFGs are generally used for high level synthesis to derive concurrent implementations of DSP applications onto parallel hardware, where subtask scheduling and resource allocation are of major concern. A schedule determines when and in which hardware unit node can be executed. So in that sense, representing any system in DFG form is important. So DFG for any DSP system can be drawn by properly choosing node and appropriately connecting them. So I am considering the same IR filter again, that is y of n is equal to a of yn minus 1 plus xn. So to implement this IR filter, we have to identify the computations. So one computation is add operation and second is multiply operation. So we need two nodes to perform this task. So first is adder and second is multiplier. A is adder node and M is multiplier node. This node is adding two signals. First is xn. This is a source node. I have not drawn source node here. And second signal is A into yn minus 1, that is output delayed by 1 cycle. So the output of M should be A times yn minus 1. And xn plus A times n minus 1 is yn, that is output of node A. So this output can be sampled from this point. It is shown by dotted line. And this yn should be delayed by 1 cycle. So this delay operation is achieved by adding weight D to this particular edge. Now talking about precedence constraint. So So edge from node A to M is having one delay element. So there is a inter iteration precedence constraint from A to M. It is denoted by EK double arrow MK plus 1. Here K denotes iteration. K denotes kth iteration. K plus 1 denotes next iteration. And edge from M to A. So M to A is having zero delay element. So there is an intra iteration precedence constraint from M to A. So it is denoted by MK single arrow EK. Same cycle. So by using this precedence constraint, we can determine the order in which nodes that is adder and multiplier will perform their execution. So node A can only fire means node A can perform its execution when all inputs are available. So it has two inputs. First is Xn, second is output of the multiplier. So Xn is a source node. Xn can fire anytime. So A has to wait for the output of M. So A can only fire when result from M is available. The result generated by node M will be consumed by node A in the same cycle. So suppose some result is generated by M in kth iteration. So in the same iteration, the result will be consumed by A. The same result will be added by A. So that's why it is represented like this: MK a single arrow EK. The result generated by MK in kth iteration will be used by A in the same iteration, that is K. And talking about the time taken to complete this sequence, so Tm will be time taken by the multiplier to perform the multiplication operation, and then A will add the output of M with Xn. So further Ta time will be taken, so total time is Tm plus Ta. Also we can determine the critical path in this circuit. So this is the sequence of combinational circuit without any delay element. There is a delay element from A to M, but this path is not having any delay element. So we can add their computation time. So Tm plus Ta, known as critical path time, and critical path is from M to A. Talking about firing of M, so M can fire if kth iteration of A is completed before the k plus 1 iteration of M. So the result generated by A in kth iteration is consumed by M in k plus 1 iteration, because there is a delay of one cycle from A to M. So whatever A will generate, that will reach to M in the next cycle. So suppose Y of K is generated in kth iteration, so this will reach to M in the next cycle, that is K plus 1 iteration. So YK will reach to the input of multiplier. So that's why it is said that kth iteration of A should be completed before K plus 1 iteration of M, and it is denoted by AK double arrow M K plus 1. So kth iteration of A should be completed before K plus 1 iteration of M. So suppose this axis is representing iteration number. So iteration number k plus 1, k plus 2, and so on. And this axis represents the output of adder, and this axis represents output of multiplier m. So suppose adder generates output ak in kth iteration, and let's ignore multiplier at this point. So this result, the output of adder, that is ak, will be transferred to multiplier in the next cycle, that is k plus 1. So this result will be transferred to multiplier the next cycle, k plus 1 cycle, and then multiplier will process the output of adder, and this adder will start processing new signal, and it will generate output ak plus 1. So the result generated by adder in the k iteration will be consumed by multiplier in the next, that is k plus 1 iteration. So kth iteration of A should be completed before the k plus 1 iteration of M for errorless computations. And the time for this sequence is Tm, because the result from A is stored in D. So it is taking Ta time, it is taking Tm time. And Tm is greater than Ta, so it will complete its execution first, and it will take some more time, that is Tm minus Ta extra time. And when M will complete its execution, it will start processing the sample received from A via this shift register. So the time taken is just Tm in this case. So DFG of FIR filter can be drawn in similar way. I am taking the same example again. Yn is equal to b0 xn plus b1 xn minus 1 plus b2 xn minus 2. So in a similar way, DFG for FIR filters can be drawn, and I have taken the same example again. Yn is equal to b0 xn plus b1 xn minus 1 plus b2 xn minus 2. So 3 multiply operation is there and 2 add operation is there. So node b0, b1 and b2 are performing this multiply operation, and node a0 and a1 is performing this add operation. So this is similar to block diagram representation, except that instead of blocks, nodes are used here. And this delay elements are for storing the past input sample. This is a direct form. And so alternative structure for this filter, that is transport form, is drawn over there. And this can be achieved by following the steps discussed in SFG. Just follow the same steps, and you can draw a transpose form from this direct form. Just you have to add delay is not included here, so add delay. So final note, DFG describe data flow among subtasks. DFG is used for high level synthesis to derive concurrent implementation of DSP applications onto parallel hardware. I also mentioned this earlier. DFG and block diagram can be used to describe both linear single rate and non-linear multi-rate DSP system, where as SFG can only be used for representing a linear single rate system.